Okay, welcome back to OpenRoads training. Today we're going to be covering how to create a horizontal tangent with Civil Accudraw. Now there's a couple things you need to do before you get started. One of those is to create a new file, name it CRL, and then you need to import your A001 file from the last video. The command that we're going to be using today in order to create these tangents is going to be the Civil Accudraw button. So if you don't have this up here already, go ahead and just type it in your search ribbon, and then it's extremely recommended that you dock it to your taskbar somewhere. So up here, down here, over here, wherever, because it's going to be used quite a bit. The other thing you need to do before you start is go ahead and set your feature definition to alignment and proposed. Turn on your chain command and your use active feature definition button. Once you do both of those, go ahead and click on your toggle Civil Accudraw button. Once you do that, you're going to notice that you have a series of buttons to the right of it. Each of these is just a different type of orientation to drawing a line, either it be DX, DY, or distance, distance. Today we're going to be using station and offset. Now, Civil Accudraw is going to work a lot like all the key-ins we had to do in order to type in station and offset. So that SO equals function we had to key in all the time. Instead of doing that, you'll now be doing Civil Accudraw instead. So once you've got that, go ahead and click it on. All right. Now once you've got that set up, go ahead and dock it back up there. Mine was acting a little finicky, so I just decided to pull a new one in. Once you do that, go to OpenRoads Modeling. So that big box up at the top left, make sure it says OpenRoads Modeling, Geometry. And then go ahead and go to lines and line between points. Once you do that, you're going to have a little pop-up box pop up next to your cursor. And that's going to be your station, your offset, which is what you've gotten selected from here. Now, in order to get this, you'll notice that the numbers change as I'm moving my mouse around. Now, to get this to set to the origin, go ahead and type O and enter. You'll see it's going to lock itself to 124 plus 51.3652, or in reality, 124 plus 51.37. Once you do that, go ahead and hit 0 in the offset bar and hit enter again. That's just basically telling it don't offset from the alignment at all. Left click to identify the point, and you'll notice that it's going to draw itself right there at the origin. Once again, so for the next thing, all you got to do is go to the offset, change it to 0, hit tab, and you'll notice it's going to lock itself to that tangent right there, or along the entire alignment. It's going to be 0 at that endpoint. Now for the station, you're going to type in 136.44.30 and hit enter. Once you do that, you're going to notice it's going to lock itself to that position completely. You go ahead and left click. That line is going to disappear back there. That's fine. It's because the A001 is actually being drawn on top of it. Don't worry about it. We know it's there. I'm not going to worry too much about it at this point. Now, the next thing you're going to do is you're going to go back to your offset. Type in negative 50. And tab, you're going to notice it's going to lock itself to negative 50 at this point. Oh, you know what? I messed up a little bit. That's fine. So go ahead and go back to this point right here. It's highlighted. I'm just going to go back to my offset. Hit O. Select this alignment in general, and then find my point here. There we go. Okay. Now go back to your offset, do O again, click the alignment. You're going to have to do this occasionally just because it has trouble reading different tangents. It's something that Bentley knows about. We've already alerted them to it. They're trying to fix it. Hopefully it'll be fixed by the time you're watching this video. If not, just know it's going to be a process you've got to follow. Clint's got a bunch of tips in here in the OpenRoads manual, so go ahead and just read through that. Now we can go ahead and type in that negative 50. And you're going to notice it's going to lock it to wherever I am on this tangent now, which is what I wanted in the first place. Now I'm going to type in my station, which is 16901.75. Tab. It's going to lock it down to this point, 50 feet off the alignment. Go ahead and left click to set it. And next. So once you've got that, just go ahead and tab to offset, hit the O button again, select the A001 alignment, tab, click in 17703.71 for the station, 17703.71. And then 0 for the offset, tab, locks it back in. So it's going to look like that. Go ahead and left click to lock it in. And then once again, go ahead and tab to offset, hit O, click on the alignment. Key in 203.30.17, press enter to lock it, and again, key in 0 for the offset, enter again, it's going to lock that further down the line just like that. So once you do that, go ahead and click again, and once you've done that, you can right click to end the command. You're going to have a purple line looking like that so far. Go to your references real quick and just undisplay it. Don't detach it because the references are based off the station's offset of A001. So by detaching it, you're actually going to break that link. So you don't want to do that. So just go ahead and turn it off and you'll have a line that looks like that. I'm going to get rid of that and escape. So that way you can see without the obstructions that this is what this is going to look like. Once you've done all that, you're done for this video, and we will see you in the next one.